How's it going, YouTube? WeskerGriff coming back with a mail day recap video. Also have several in-persons to show you guys, so I'm going to dive into the video right away because I made this video before and it was actually 12 minutes. So I don't want a 12-minute video. I want this to be try to be under 5 minutes, so I'm going to kind of go through this stuff. I did get one TTM in. I did recently send out a new batch of TTMs. I sent out about like 12 to 13 new TTMs to mostly baseball players. Current baseball players too, but this was one of the few that I sent to a retired player, but it only took 4 days, so it was nice to see this come back pretty quickly. It's coming from Ray Semproch. He's signed here in blue Sharpie right above Philadelphia Phillies, and this was one of the cards that Adrian Gonzalez fan 23 sent me a while back for Just Because. So I did say in the video I would put these cards to good use. That gets signed. So thank you very much, Francisco, for sending me this. And thank you, Mr. Semproch, for signing this. So nice to get a TTM in. Took about 4 to 5 days. And that's 1 point for Team Martinez for the YouTube Fantasy League. So that's cool. And then, like I said, I also went to the Orioles-Indians game this Monday coming up. Well, last Monday. But it was alumni night. So they had members from the Orioles alumni there, and they had two members from the 83 World Series team. They had Sammy Stewart there, and I didn't have any cards for these guys to sign, but fortunately the Orioles do have like these 4x6 signed postcards that they hand out, so I was able to get Sammy Stewart, another Sammy Stewart, Bill Swaggerty, and another Bill Swaggerty. So those were the two members of the 83 team, and then they also had Dave Ford there. So Dave Ford here, and then Dave Ford here. And I was real happy that it was alumni night. I didn't know that going down because I really went to get the Cleveland Indians. I really wanted to get Mark Reynolds and Michael Bourne and also Jason Kipnis. But the game I went to had was a rain delay, and they had the tarp on the field all the way to like 6:50, and the players didn't come out to 6:55, and the game started at normal time, which was 7:05. So obviously the players had literally no time to sign because they had to do warm-ups and everything. But before warm-ups, Justin Masterson did come out, and I got him to sign this archives card. He also included a Bible verse. So that was pretty cool to get Justin Masterson, who's a pretty good pitcher for the Cleveland Indians, and also get those alumni autographs. The alumni autographs, guys, are not for trade. I know a bunch of people that I owe stuff to that are also Orioles fans, so I'll probably send some of the extras to them. So none of that is for trade. And then, like I said before I start the video, I don't know if I did or didn't say it, but I got two really massive eBay pickups that I would like to show you guys. The first one here is out of Topps Finest. Finest Moments 2011, numbered 162 out of 274. And this guy was kind of a white whale for me trying to add him to my collection, but I finally got one of Roy Halladay. So beyond excited to finally add a Roy Halladay autograph to my collection. It's one of the jersey autos with the away jersey, the gray jersey. And I've just been trying so long to get an autograph of him, and I paid a fantastic price. I only paid $24 for this card, and if you would have told me I would have paid $24 for this like 2 years ago, I would have called you crazy, because Roy Halladay stuff is really insane sometimes. I know he did an in-person signing here in Philadelphia at one of the card shows for $200. Any item, $200. Inscriptions, an additional like $20. So he is one of the most expensive autographs to get, and I know he has a couple products in Triple Threads and a couple products in Marquee, and those easily sell for close to $80 to $100. And this card here on Topps Finest, there's a couple buy it now for $50, so I was really, really lucky to get this for $24, so extremely excited to finally get an autograph of one of the hardest guys to get in baseball. He's really horrible in person, and he does not sign TTM, so really happy to finally get Mr. Halladay for my Phillies PC. And then, like I said, next, if you're on the Facebook autograph forum, you'll know about this next pickup, but what I did was I bought a certified autograph baseball from JSA. I bought it off a real reputable seller on eBay. But when I bought the ball, I didn't check the JSA number, and you should never do that. You should always check the number before you put a bid on it, and I was stupid. I didn't do that, and the number was not in the database, but I already put the bid in. So I contacted the seller and asked him about it, and what he told me was that he just got it certified a couple days ago, which did make sense because the seller lives in New Jersey where the JSA certification store is. So I did give him the benefit of the doubt, and I have dealt with this person before, and they're a really good seller. So he just told me I had to wait 3 weeks for it to get into the database, but I waited about 4.5 to 5 weeks and still was not in the database. It was really bothering me because I did spend pretty good money on it. So he told me he would give me a full refund, but that I also had to check with JSA. So I checked with JSA, I called them. They told me I had to email photos of the baseball and the certification number over to them, which is actually what BigDog7499 told me I had to do. So I did that, and it turned out it was legit. JSA put it in the database, and they just told me that they were really backed up recently because they've had a lot of submissions. So I was really excited to finally add this to my collection. This is a nice signed Hall of Fame inscription certified JSA baseball of Brooks Robinson, Orioles Hall of Famer, the human vacuum cleaner. So nice Hall of Fame inscription there. It's on a brand new baseball, an official Major League Rollins baseball, and there is the certification number right there. And here's also the JSA paper that they give you. But I'm going to tell you guys what I paid for this. I paid $45 shipped. And in my humble opinion, that's highway robbery, because here's how I'm going to break that down for you. This is a brand new baseball that costs $15. So you have $45, $15 for the baseball. To get this baseball certified by JSA costs $14. So I paid around $16 for the signature. So $16 for a Brooks Robinson autograph is phenomenal. So extremely, extremely excited to add that to my collection. I really think I got probably one of the best deals you can find for a baseball like that. And I was surprised I won it because I put the bid in like about 3 days before, which is not something you really do, but I didn't think I was going to win it, so that's why I did that. So thanks, guys, for watching the video. If you have any comments or questions, just leave them down in the box there. And thanks for watching. I hope everyone out there is doing well, and take care. Peace.